Hello everyone, we're Small Town Nita Works. I'm Jade.
I'm Kim.
And this is Floss Tube number 62. We're back and she's in good health, I reckon.
Yep.
Hopefully.
I hope so too.
I'll be upset if I get home with something.
You know, all those things are going around, but
I reckon everybody's got flu and everything else and running rampant right now.
Yep. Thankfully mine wasn't too bad and didn't last too long. About 3 days of
yuck.
And then I was on the mend. I just had to have a few days to get some energy back. Yeah. And I got some.
Yeah. Yeah, she got enough energy to be productive.
Yep.
I wish I had that much.
Welcome back and welcome to anybody that's new.
Yep.
We appreciate you joining us.
Got my Christmas gear on.
Yeah, she's
Merry
all festive.
Be with you.
I'm not festive today. I just have Bon Jovi living on a prayer.
I was like, duh, why don't I wear my Christmas t-shirts on this? So I probably have a different one on. I also bought a sweater, another sweater.
I would have worn my
Christmas sweater, but it's too hot for all that.
Would have worn my small town Christmas shirt that Courtney got us, but it's dirty.
Yeah, if we have our show this Saturday,
yep.
We're supposed to wear those.
Yes,
so I should probably find it. It's probably in my basket of laundry.
Yeah, we're supposed to have a show Saturday.
But it has been raining
mm-hmm.
for like a week and a half straight, it feels like. And it is annoying.
Yes.
It is depressing and it's
just
muddy
blah.
And it's
just yuck. With a side of yuck.
I feel like I haven't seen the sun in like, like that
song.
One song.
I was like, isn't that a song?
Yeah,
I ain't seen
the sunshine in three damn days.
That's Sheryl Crow and Kid Rock.
Yep. Anywho, yeah, it's bad. It's been more than 3 days. It's been like 3 weeks. It's been at least a week and a half.
Yeah, at least a week.
Yeah.
It feels a lot longer.
It started
before
last week's video, I think. But I mean, it took a break for a minute, but it's just been pouring down constantly.
Yep, it's ugly.
So if we yawn, I yawn all the time, but like I've been yawning more because I'm just like, I have no energy for this weather.
I know. I feel so much better and feel like I can be so much more productive whenever it's bright
and
sunny
bright,
outside.
Yeah, this is just,
I mean, now
depressing.
Don't get me wrong, I don't like the heat, but I do like sunshine.
I love
and
the
you
heat.
Don't have to have both at the same time.
I love the heat.
So, here I go.
Already.
I like a bright, sunny day in the wintertime. Not the hot, scorching summertime.
I'm trying to get myself centered here. So, we got our Advents finally because we were...
Yes.
We were behind
the day or two. We started our Advents. So, if you guys weren't with us last year, we do a stitchy Advent for each other. So, we'll show you guys what we got over the past week.
I don't know which days.
Oh, no, me either.
So,
and I had a couple of bonuses.
Yep, she did.
Jade has a couple of bonuses, but she told me to put those in her stocking, so that's what I'm doing.
Yeah. Give me a couple extra things. Let's see, put these here. I think we've got 8 days. Yeah, 8 days of stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah, trying to get out of these little tiny plastic baggies. Sure, though.
Oh, yeah, I have eight, but
that?
I thought I had an extra.
What was that?
My thread.
That was an extra. Did you open today's?
Yeah.
So I might write 2, 3, 7, 8.
right. That's weird.
Was it the scissors? I'm just trying to think of stuff that's laying on there. Who knows?
No, I didn't get any scissors. I don't know. I'm missing something.
Anyway. Well, I'll think about it in a second when we finish showing these. So, I got me some... She got me some...
Unless my cat's batted
one
something
off. One of them did fall off earlier.
I know. I picked it up. It was this one.
I got a selection of classic color works, gentle art, and weak style works here. So, got Really Tilly. What is it?
I remember one of them. It's in there.
Ladybug. Presidential Blue. And this is the gentle art one. Very pretty. So pretty. It's even like deeper blue than what it's showing up. Got Manor Red. Kentucky Bluegrass. And Blue Bonnet. It's really pretty. And then I got this needle minder. Super cute. And then I got some of these. And that was all of mine. What is it? Where is it?
The first needle minder. Oh. It's stuck to my cart.
Oh, I'll go grab it because that's really cute.
It is, but am I still missing something?
No.
Or was there just one extra?
I think there was just one extra.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'm good then.
I think.
Then that would be it.
I'll go grab it in a minute.
Okay. I can take all mine out.
You don't have to. I only had two that were in Ziplocs.
Oh, yeah. That's because... I don't know. Maybe I couldn't get them to fit. Oh, yeah. Because I packaged yours different.
Well, those classic colorworks don't... Oh, yeah. I guess they did. I just threw hers in the little baggies into her stuff. Let me go grab her others, and she will show you her...
Yes, I will.
...advent stuff.
She got me Weak Style Works Swiss Chocolate. Very pretty brown. And Classic Colorworks Just Rust. A pretty burnt orange. Tennessee Red Clay by Classic Colorworks. Little House Brown by Classic Colorworks. A light brown. And then I got some 14 count Ada Misty Blue. And then this is the one that I forgot because I stuck it to my card in my craft room when I opened it. So cute. A needle minder with the little kitty cat with the Santa Claus hat on. So cute.
I had that in my Amazon cart for...
It's adorable.
Probably since before last Christmas.
And then this one came in this cute little bag. And I absolutely love this one. I was like, yes! Yes, because when I was looking for her stuff, I saw this and was like, oh, man, I'd like to have one of those. I was like, that fits me perfect. But it's a needle minder. It says True Crime Addict. Because I love me some true crime. I love watching documentaries and stuff.
Yeah.
So, I love that. It's really cute.
Just and then use your needle minders.
I know. I do some, see?
Yeah, but those aren't.
I use them. And then she got me this, which is awesome. It's a double-sided organizer for my floss. Yeah. Much larger than the last one that she got me.
It's exactly like the one that I have at home. And I had wanted to get her last year, but I could only find the little one that she has. But that thing is busting out of
and I have stuff. So much that ain't organized.
Floss or
so,
on bobbins.
So, yeah. I'm gonna have to get me some more bobbins and reorganize my floss.
You have some. Well, you might have a little.
I do have some, but I don't know if I have enough.
I didn't get you any.
So, but I love that and needed it. But she always just outdoes me on the Advent, and I'm like,
I just know what you need, though you don't ask for it.
The only thing she told me that she needed was those thimble pads.
Because I go through them.
So I got her some.
That's really, I mean, of course you can always use floss and needle minders, but like, I go through those.
But things. That's what we got in our Stitchy Advents from each other.
Yep.
So much fun. We love it.
Do you want to talk about these or do you want to do our whips?
Whatever you want to do.
What do you want to do?
Let's just do that and get it out of the way.
Okay. We're just going to show, since it's getting closer to Christmas time, we're just going to showcase our...
Yeah, showcase our
Christmassy patterns.
Our Christmas and winter patterns.
So, this one was in the kitchen, so I'll hold it up here. This is her old-fashioned hot cocoa that Mom designed and stitched.
Yep.
Super cute. And this is just a chalkboard sled from the...
I think it's Dollar General.
Dollar...
I think it was Dollar General.
Dollar General or Family Dollar. We can never remember. Anyways.
One of those places.
Yep. So there's that one. And then we have on the mantle here. This is our Christmas in a small town. I know it's hard to see, but Mom told me I can't lean
I didn't
back
want her
there
to
break
lean,
the chair.
I didn't want her to lean back and get them because I don't want her to break my chair.
And then we have right here.
Yep.
Is the Christmas movie stitch that she designed and made real pretty stuff. And then we have Winter in a Small Town as well, all of which are available on our Etsy.
Yes. So if you're need, you know, I know.
Nobody needs it.
Nobody needs any more to stitch one. Because that's how we are too. But, you know, somehow, yeah. Some way we continue to stitch and continue to, you know.
Yeah. I'm letting Mom take over my new
pattern.
Hoard
up the patterns.
Scoop back in here now.
So, anyway, if you're interested in those four, check those out on our Etsy under Small Town Needleworks.
Do we want to show it? Or like a fold it in half or something?
Yeah, just half of that part. Yeah, she stitched
like
part
half?
Of... Sure. She stitched part of this, and then I'm going to finish stitching it because she just doesn't have time, and I seem to go...
She goes a lot quicker.
Quicker.
So I'm going to let her... I designed but she's going to stitch
it. So we can get it up,
I have,
you know,
like,
just in case somebody wants to stitch it before Christmas.
Present.
That she's trying to get done.
And I have those three or four Christmas ones that I have had... I've gotten and or had since last Christmas, and I want to get those done. So I knew if I didn't let her do it, even though she had offered, and I was like, no, it's fine. And then I was like, does the offer still stand?
Yeah, I was like, you want me? Because I really wanted to stitch it because I don't know, there's something about designing your own and like stitching them. And I know you wanted to. Mm-hmm. And I get that. But I feel like we're probably going to end up stitching each other's over time.
Yeah.
Depending on who designs quicker, what we've got going on, what she's got going on, you know, that type thing. But it's like, I was going, do I need to design something else? Because I felt the itch to, like, design something else so I could stitch something else that we've designed. Which is crazy, but it's just different when you're stitching something that you came up with versus someone else's. So
we had, Mom had this idea long before we ever started designing.
Mm-hmm.
And then I kind of brought it to life, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And
she
gave me some ideas for other parts of it. But we'll give a little sneaky peek.
Yep. There's your sneak peek.
Yep.
It's going to be so cute.
And then I will let her finish it. I know she'll have it finished by next week because that's just how she rolls. This is probably the more difficult part of it was what I had stitched.
But if we have, if for some reason we have it finished before next week, then we'll go ahead and put it up on Etsy and on Instagram and Facebook.
I brought her the piece to finish it on, and she's got everything here to do it. So,
yeah. So I'm excited to finish that up for.
Yep.
Excited to see how it turns out.
I think it'll be cute.
It is.
I mean, it already is cute.
Yeah, it is cute.
I mean, I'm pretty proud of that, this part.
Yeah,
and me too.
I'm proud of it all. Speaking of proud, Jade graduates tomorrow. Well,
I will have graduated. She will have graduated by the time you see it.
Yep. If, well, no, we won't have, I was going to say we'd have a picture, but we won't because you're editing tonight.
Oh, yeah, no. I can show next week.
Yeah, next week we'll have pictures of her in her cap and gown.
Yeah.
So.
I ain't done that in 12 years.
But you did, you tell them you did pass? You didn't tell them, did you?
Oh, no, I passed.
She Wait. Did pass.
Yeah. Did I tell them last week?
No, because you didn't find out till Monday, right?
Was it this week? Oh, yeah, yeah. It was my last test. I'm so scattered brained when
so
it comes
she
to
did
it.
Pass, so
I passed my barely passed my final exam, but I passed it, and then it passed the class as a whole. It wasn't like an A or anything by any means.
That's okay. That's all that matters.
But, you know, C's get degrees. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm saying.
She has an associate's degree in, what did you say it was?
Huh? Go ahead.
I don't know.
I thought you knew.
I don't know. Is it what I've been saying all along? Because I thought you said it was applied science or something.
It is. It's both.
Okay, well, you tell them.
I have an associate's of applied sciences. My degree is in electrical electronic engineering for computer systems.
Yeah, that.
So, associate applied science. So, the dental people, I looked at her degree that was hanging on the wall. Hers is an associate of applied science, but it's in dentistry or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
cool.
It's just a broader term for it, I guess. I don't know.
Awesome. So, we're going to her graduation tomorrow, which is, if you're watching when this, you're watching, when it comes out, yeah, then
it will be done.
It will be done.
And we'll be eating a good dinner.
Yeah. So we're going to eat to celebrate.
Eat at my favorite restaurant.
Yeah.
Carrabba's. Love Carrabba's and their bread, but.
Yep. Good. So y'all give Jade some love. I'm proud of her.
I did this for myself and I probably never do it again.
Especially the end. It was killing her.
Too much. You get towards the end and your brain just shuts off. It's like the ultimate senioritis. It's bad, especially when you're an adult and don't have like your parents breathing down your neck and you can just quit if you wanted to.
I still try to breathe down her neck just a little bit every now and then.
It's really easy to want to give up.
I still would say, did you study? Have you studied?
Yeah, and then she'd get an earful about it.
No, I never was bad.
No, I meant like an earful about how crap the seven horses are and stuff.
Yeah.
Anywho.
So.
I have two more whips. What do you got?
I have two very small little whip here. Mm-hmm. And this whip. This fully finished and all this.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You do a whip.
You do whip.
You do whip and I do whip. And then you do whip and I do whip.
So I brought this back out, but I barely got anything on it done. But it is part 8 of the 9-part series of Farmhouse Christmas Farm Folk by Little House Needleworks.
And it's on Toast.
Yes.
Toast to 14 Count Ada from Hobby Lobbies.
I basically just put all these windows in. That's all I had time for. So, but it's a small progress.
Yeah. It's super cute, though. I like the little people.
Yeah, it is cute.
And the little doggo. Oh, well, this is the one where you were like, oh, I've screwed up the bird and the fence or whatever.
Yep.
I remember now.
I think the only thing that I have not screwed up on and not and went back to fix it is our own patterns. I'm not saying that. I mean, I did screw up. I left something out, but I didn't screw it up. I did leave back stitching out on our patterns, but she was able to go back and fix it. Uh-huh. But as far as stitching our patterns, I make sure that they're right. And if I find something wrong, I go back and fix it. I don't just leave it like I do when I'm stitching for my own pleasure because I want it to look right.
That one that I, the sneak peek that we showed y'all, I had screwed up a whole like part and had to
cut it out and go back. This one up too, but no, I'm not
fixing that one.
I was like, no, it looks fine.
Okay, this is my caterpillar cross stitch stitch into Christmas. I realized I hadn't hardly done anything besides that one y'all seen and like a little bit on my Christmas present one that I'm doing. So I was like, I have to get at least one or two of these done. I think I got one done.
The candle?
Mm-hmm. After I had finished, and I did all this like last night, because I was like, I gotta have something else.
Very cute though.
Oh, well, let me show you this. This is quick snip, because that's the actual pattern, but.
So cute.
I worked on this little guy.
Very cute. Those would all make cute little ornaments.
Yeah, if you did them separately.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Ooh, you could make like a little mini advent calendar tree.
You could.
Like get one of those little mini trees.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be. I'll keep it for in the future because that definitely ain't happening anytime soon. Not to mention, I don't have enough room for another tree in my house.
Nor do I. So I worked on the Christmas Rules by Primrose Cottage Stitches. I know I'm probably 3 weeks behind. I don't know how long. I don't even know what week we're on anymore. But it was a stitch along with Cornhusker State Stitchers. And there's what it looks like. Christmas Rules. And I'm just using
what you had.
Yeah, whatever floss I had that I liked. I'm not so sure I like that. I might change that.
Put it like a dark green or something. Make it kind of blend.
Even though that's, I mean, it's that. I know, but I still, you know, and I'm like, it still just looks so stark to me.
It does. I would do like a dark gray. Like that one that's in the other
place. Yeah, I'm probably going to.
Just because it's bright compared to these little bit dingier colors.
But I worked on week 4, which is hang your stockings. But what we were just discussing was this black.
It's like really bright.
It's really stark amongst all the other colors that I'm using. And I don't think I like it. So I'm probably going to go back and take that out and use a different color. And there is a few more places that black is used in the pattern. The bottom of the sled and the snowman hat are both black, which looks good with the colors they used, but it just stands out too much for me.
Need a darker.
So I think I'm going to
a dingier gray.
Figure out a different color for that instead of the black.
3799.
Yeah. So, but I did all that.
Sure that's this week. I think this color would look good. 3799, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, this one. I think it would look better. Or even 4099. Or there's 535 maybe.
Yeah, maybe that. Maybe that.
Yep.
But, because as soon as I put it on there, I was like, woo, man, that's just...
Sticks out like a sore
thumb.
That's
a lot.
All right. My last whip is the Outlander piece that I'm doing. I got this from Sew Marie Studio on Etsy. And it is, I'm stitching it on 14 count Ada vintage oat from Hobby Lobby.
It's really cool. Kind of looks antiqued.
It is called antique oat. I realized that.
Is it? I didn't even pay attention.
I was just saying.
I know, but I was like,
antique oat.
Mm-hmm.
To nope. Make it look antique. So, the rings, the lavender, Jamie's sign for his print shop, and Claire's red dress that she wore when they were in France.
France.
And I've got that done. So, all of these are done except for the back stitch. I'm going to do all the back stitch last. They're half stitches.
I was like, what's that?
It's just how it is. They're half stitches, and then you have,
I got you,
like the outline there.
Right. Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah, it looks a little funny, but
it won't though.
No, not once I get it. Den.
Cute.
I love it. And I am gonna redo this one again. This will be one that I do for myself.
So, I found a finish that I did,
what was earlier this year?
Earlier this year, and I was like,
July.
And I was like, I need to fully finish that so I can get it out.
Oh, I have so many I need to finish from last year, I just remembered, including the little nutcracker.
I have a ton, and they're not all going to get done. They're just not.
I might have to look at a few pieces from your storage here.
And that sticky board, you go through it so fast. Like, we had a bunch. Now there's not much in there at all.
I have a couple pieces at my house.
But anyway, it was the Christmas time stitch along with Fat Quarter Shop that we did. It was a mystery stitch along. But, of course, it's all out there now, and it was a free pattern. But anyway, I finished it into a pillow, and it says Merry Little Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And I just used some holly fabric that I had. I did the trimming around the front, or whatever you want to call that. So, but I think it turned out cute, so now I can actually use it. And I just hand sewed the bottom up right there.
Did I call that the lucky nutcracker? Oh, but I didn't.
I don't know.
That caterpillar cross stitch one that I did is stitch into Christmas. I just had to say, like, thought I, like, lucky nutcracker was in my brain, and I was like, I hope I didn't call that lucky nutcracker. Because it's not. It's stitch into Christmas, the advent one.
I was like, I don't know why you're asking me, because I can't hear from one minute to the next.
Yeah.
So, and then I got busy sewing for once.
Yeah.
I was like, if I can just get in there and start cutting some fabric out. And so that's what I did. I cut fabric for an entire day. And then over the next 2 days, I put together ironed. Sewed. So, no pun intended. Mm-hmm. These will all be in our Etsy shop at some point in the very near future. So if you're interested in any of them, check out our Etsy. And make sure that you like our Etsy store. That way, it will notify you when we add things to the shop.
Huh? When we put stuff up.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So I have 4 zipper notion pouches. And these are all Christmas. So there's this one.
Cute.
Black and white buffalo check. And then on the other side, it looks like this. So, there's that zipper notion pouch. Then there's this one. The little chalkboard gingerbread cookies.
I really like that one.
And then there's this one with the Christmas kitties. And then on the inside of it is the holly. And then this one is the Christmas chickens and roosters, which I thought was adorable because some of them have crocheted scarves on.
Scarves, and then they have the little Santa hats.
Mm-hmm. And the inside is the green. So those are the zipper notion pouches that will be going up. And then, you want to help with these?
Yep.
So then we have 2 of the chicken fabric cross-stitch clutches. So there's these 2.
This is the only difference.
Yeah. One has red, one has green wool needle minder. So there's those. And then I have this one. That's the Christmas tree farm with the red and black buffalo check. There's the inside.
And this one's the little Christmas kitties. And then on this side, it has like a partial strip of holly.
Mm-hmm.
And then it has green buttons and needle minder.
So then we have this one that is a little strip of red in the gingerbread recipe chalkboard fabric. There's the inside of that one.
This one is the farmhousey barn hot cocoa
buffalo plaid.
Strip of buffalo plaid here too.
Mm-hmm.
And then it has a red needle minder with black buttons. Sorry, red needle minder, black buttons. I'm mumbling. Sorry. Try.
Okay, we have 2. Vinyl front project bags. The only difference is the zipper color and
the zipper pull.
So this one has the blue and it's the hot cocoa.
This one has like a cream brown and then a green zipper pull.
Yep.
Green zipper pull, brown zipper.
Then we have the chickens and the green fabric. See the little crocheted scarf around its neck? So cute.
This one is the hot cocoa farmhouse buffalo chick. Has a red zipper, and I think this is a hunter green. The zipper, yeah.
And then we have 2 of these that are the same except for the zippers and the zipper pulls. This one has the white zipper with the green zipper pull.
And this one has a black zipper
Red? Yeah,
black. Well, I was trying to make sure that was black. Black yeah. zipper and a red zipper pull.
And it's the Christmas Tree Farm. And then we have one more. And it is the Christmas Kitties and the Holly. So, there is what will be coming to our Etsy. If it's not up by the time you see the video, it should be up within a few days. So, so be checking the Etsy shop and or Instagram, Facebook for notifications.
I need to show them. So, mom had like an extra.
Oh, yeah.
It's hard to see with how dark it is and how bright this light is. She had an extra in her advent calendar. It was, I found on clearance, a pretty decent sized spool of thread
mm-hmm.
that variegated from red, white, and green.
Mm-hmm.
And she used that.
I used that on all of the Christmas projects.
So it's hard to tell on here.
I didn't tell on that one.
You can see it. It's just hard to see it in this light. You kind of see it where it variates from white and reds.
Yep. The thread goes white, red, green, white, red, green. Very cute.
Yep.
So that was also in my advent.
It was an extra because I honestly missed it on my desk somehow when I was making up her advent calendar.
Well, same. I missed, one of hers came late and then one of them I missed because it was late in my pile of
junk
stuff where I stitch. So, but there's that. So be on the lookout for those in the Etsy shop if you're interested in any of those.
Last week we announced that we wanted to do Christmas card exchange with you all.
Louder.
I'm talking. You leave me alone. Over here piercing my eardrums.
I can't help it. At least everybody hears me.
I said.
You said.
I'm going to smack you. Did you hear that? Kidding. Last week we decided or announced that we were wanting to do a card exchange with whoever wanted to send one. So we received this one last week, right?
Yes.
We had this one last. It's up here. It's hard for y'all. I can't see it, but y'all can see it. And then we had some addresses from a couple friends of ours. So, we won't show their addresses, but these will be going out. And then mom's still keeping a check on her P.O. box.
Yeah.
And then, last week's giveaway, or the redraw
mm-hmm.
for Christmas cookies, Linda Seaman. I spelled her name wrong when we was doing the video last week, and I second guessed it. I was like, that don't sound right. I was like, but it's even how we spell it. The way she spells it is the way you spell it. Like,
in the Navy.
In the Navy.
Yeah.
I don't know what I was thinking. I was out of my mind last week, I guess. But we got that giveaway going out to her.
Mm-hmm. And then we have a new giveaway.
Yep. We have this one. It's the Tiny Modernist. Bake the world a better place. We didn't really have any Christmas ones we were willing to let go of. So,
yeah.
I figured this was probably a good one because I know a lot of people bake a lot.
During the holidays.
During the holidays. So, here it is. And it is super cute.
It is cute.
But if you would like to enter to win this one, just tell us... Or just say the word bake. You can, and we would also like to know what you bake for Christmas.
Yeah.
So tell us what you bake.
Use or the word bake during the bake. Holiday season at all. You know.
Yeah.
Whether you bake pies, cookies, cakes, all the above.
Yeah.
Or even if you don't bake and you make like fudge or
something
else, you can tell us about that too.
Or don't bake. But you want to enter to win for some reason.
You can
reason.
Just say, to say I don't bake. Bake.
So, yeah. So, make sure you comment on this video, the word bake, before December 15th at 12 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Yeah.
Before then, so we can choose a winner or do the... What is that thing called? Random
comment picker.
Random YouTube comment picker, yep.
And we also have a shout out.
Oh, yeah.
I just covered it up, yep. We also have a shout out. This week's shout out to under 1,000 subscribers is the Fanciful Flamingo, and her name is Alicia. She is in Florida. So you guys head over and check her out. I think you'll like her. I think she's got maybe 11 videos.
Oh yeah, I love when you were skimming through. Was she had like samplers and I can't remember.
I don't know.
What all she had.
Sometimes I do good to find the people that are under 1,000. So I don't always have time to watch through all the videos. So, but I think you guys will like her. So head on over and give her a shout and let her know that we sent you there. We would appreciate it, and I'm sure she will too.
Yep.
Is there anything else?
No, I don't think so. Don't forget, if you would like these.
Oh, yes. Yeah, check out our Etsy shop for these three patterns and the hot cocoa pattern. If you're interested or need something else to stitch.
Nobody needs it.
No.
I think that's it.
So... Well, we will see you guys next week with bells on.
Yep. Oh, and if you weren't here last week or didn't see last week's video and want to send us a card, I'll be sure to put our P.O. box down below as well.
Yep. If you send us a card, we'll get you one back out to you as soon as we get your address.
Yep.
Have a good week, you all. Bye.
Bye.